Hello dear students, observe these pictures carefully. All of you would have seen a pin holder in your school office. You may have seen that in this pin holder, some pins are attached to the cap. Why do the pins get attached to the cap of the pin holder? What could be there in that cap? Does it attract objects other than pins? What are they? And observe this picture. Here is the metal sticker stuck to the door of the refrigerator. And also you might have seen some other metal stickers like this are also stuck to the doors of the iron almirahs at our homes. What is there in those stickers? Which makes them stick to the iron doors? Do they stick to wooden doors or plastic doors too? So let us find, children, which objects that get stuck to the cap of this pin holder. Okay. For that, we will do one small activity. This is the pin holder you are observing. In that pin holder, I am keeping some materials like these. You are observing different kinds of materials like rubber bands, paper pieces, ball pins, iron nails, ball pins you are observing. That is the stick, small sticks. Those are small sticks. Stapler pins, iron nail. Yeah, you are observing iron nail. We kept different kinds of materials like pieces of paper, ball pin, iron nail, small sticks, wooden sticks, etc. in that ball pin. Let's close the cap of that pin holder. Now make it upside down. See what will remain in that. Yeah, what you are observing? The pins, ball pins, are attached to the cap of the pin holder. You are observing the pieces of paper and some wooden sticks. Yeah, like this. Okay. Like the same way, we will observe why some stickers stuck to the iron doors and some are not. This is the door of the refrigerator. Observe carefully. That metal sticker stuck to the door of the refrigerator. If you observe this, but it is not a stick. Why does this happen? If we observe the back side of that stickers, then what is there the back side of the sticker. See, you are observing some interesting kind of ring here. So what is that? What makes the sticker to stick onto that iron door? We will find what is that in this lesson. Our lesson name is playing with magnets. In this lesson, the learner going to learn that differentiates between magnetic and non-magnetic materials, conducts activity to make their own magnet and magnetic compass, identifies the magnet's usage in their daily life, makes a model of magnetic toy, gives reason for why some magnets repel each other, explains the process of magnetic induction, finds the directions with the help of magnetic compass. Okay? Here, which materials is needed to make magnets? You know that a toy contain that material contains some magnet behind it. So that is why that metal sticker stuck to the metal door. So what material is needed to make magnets? Usually magnets are made up of steel or iron. However, special alloys of iron, nickel, copper, cobalt and aluminium can be made into powerful magnets now. Right now, the strongest magnet is currently known as neodymium. These are the magnets made by human. Then what is the natural magnet? Who discovered it first? How were these magnets discovered first? I will show you one story, that is the discovery of magnet. Around 2005 years ago, there lived an old shepherd named Magnus. He used to take his goats and sheep to the hills for grazing. He always carried a wooden stick which had an iron cap on its lower end. One day, while his goats were grazing, Magnus dipped his stick into a spring of water and poked at the pebbles and stones at the bottom with it. Suddenly, he felt something pulling its stick. When he took it out of water, he saw a stone stuck to the iron cap. The stone which Magnus pulled out was called lodestone. Lodestone is a natural magnet. It is a natural magnet and possesses the property of attracting iron. Magnet's property is attracting iron objects or iron material. That is the way magnet is discovered by the person Magnus. Okay children, I want to show you some shapes of magnets. You are observing different shapes of magnets here. This is harsh shoe magnet, bar magnet, disc magnet, ring magnet. And observe these also. These are also the same. Harsh shoe magnet, bar magnet, disc magnet, ring magnet. Now let us find the materials used by us in our day-to-day life, which are magnetic and which are non-magnetic. We can identify them with the help of this activity. Okay? You are observing different kinds of materials in this video. First take one bar magnet and test all these materials with that bar magnet. Divide the material into attracted by magnet and not attracted by magnet. See, this one is attracting. Not attracted by magnet. Yeah, it is attracted. So keep this one here. Rubber bands. Are they attracted? No. Safety pin? Yeah. It was attracted by magnet. Comb? Okay. Non-magnetic. Yeah. Razor? Attracted. Tip top? Attracted. Pencil? Not attractive. Scale, plastic scale, not attractive. Bolt, attractive. Stainless steel spoon, not attractive. Piece of paper is not attracted by magnet. Observe the chalk. Chalk handle is plastic and this one is iron. Iron is attracted. Eraser. It is not attracted. See, the sharpener blade is attracted by the magnet, but the outer cap is not. Both magnetic and non-magnetic materials are there in the sharpener and also in chalk. So that is why she kept that aside. See, in the key, this branch is not attracted and this steel is here. This one is attracted, iron material. So in this bunch of key also, some are attracted and some are not attracted by the magnet. Okay, children, you have seen different kinds of materials which are attracted by magnet and these are not attracted by magnet. These are attracted by magnet. In this group of materials, some part has attracted by magnet and some parts are not attracted by magnets. Okay. Now let us sum up. The materials that are attracted by magnets are called magnetic materials. The materials that are not attracted by magnet are called non-magnetic materials. Okay. In soil we find some magnetic particles, magnetic materials. Can we separate iron fillings from soil? For that, what we have to do to prepare iron fillings from soil? Take a bar magnet and roll it in the soil in your school ground for some time. Pull out the magnet. What do you find? Does anything get attached to the magnet? Yes, you find something on magnet. Okay, that dark particles of soil sticking to the magnet is called iron fillings. Okay, I think that particles looks like this. Okay, those particles looks like this. Yes, which part of magnet attracts more iron fillings? You have seen different shapes of magnets like bar, horseshoe, ring, disc magnets. Which part of magnet attracts more iron filling? From which part of the magnet do you feel more difficulty in removing iron fillings? While removing iron fillings, do you feel any difficulty? Now let us see some activities. Which part of magnet attracts more iron fillings through this experiment? What you are observing? I kept one magnet below the paper. Now I am holding the magnetic material, that is iron fillings, on the paper. See how magnet is attracting that iron fillings. You are observing the iron fillings, how they are spreading over here, where they get stuck more. This is the magnetic field. You are observing the magnetic field. How far, what is the area that is attracting, how much area that is attracted by this magnet, you are observing here in this magnetic field. Now observe this one also. This is a bar magnet. I am pouring the iron fillings over the magnet here. Okay. See children, where the iron fillings attach more. If you observe here, edges of the ending of the starting edge and the ending edge, these two edges have more iron fillings. That means where the attracting power is more for this bar magnet at the poles, we call them as poles. Poles have the more magnetic attracting power. Okay, then we will find the directions with the help of bar magnet. Okay, for this we will do one activity like this. You are observing the bar magnet which is freely suspended, and now it is showing the directions of north and south poles. That means if we freely suspended a bar magnet like this, it always shows north and south directions. So this property of magnet is called directional property. We use this property to make a magnetic compass. Okay, now I will show you magnetic compass. This is the magnetic compass. You are observing a small box with a glass covering over it. A magnetized needle is provided, pivoted inside the box, that can rotate freely. The compass also has a dial with the directions marked on it. You are observing the directions. Okay, the compass is kept at the place where we wish to know the direction. Its needle indicates the north-south direction. North-south direction. Its needle indicates the north-south direction when it comes to rest. The compass is then rotated until the north and south marked on the dial are exactly below the two ends of the needles. Okay? We can use this compass or magnetic compass in ships, aeroplanes, when we go for a mountaineering. And also army people also uses this magnetic compass to know the direction where they are exactly, in which direction they are. To know about the direction, they use this magnetic compass. And now I want to show one interesting property of these magnets, that is attraction and repulsion between two magnets. With the help of this activity, I will show that. See, these two are the bar magnets. Every magnet has a north and south poles. These are the poles of this magnet, north and south poles. See, north pole is taken near to the north pole of other magnets. They are repulsing each other. Here you observe repulsion. And now change the directions. This is the south pole of this magnet. And here we are keeping the same pole, like south. What will happen now? Attraction or repulsion? Yeah, you are observing the repulsion. Between south pole and south pole, you observe the repulsion. And now change the direction again. And observe now what will happen. This is the north direction in this magnet. Here, this is south direction in this magnet. Yeah, now what happened? Attracted or repulsion change? What you observe? See, south pole and this one is north pole. Now observe what will happen, attraction or repulsion? Yeah, attraction happened. That means, what did you observe in this activity? You notice that like poles, like north-north or south-south, repel each other. And unlike poles, like north-south, attract each other. Okay? Do you know, children? Our Earth is also a big magnet. It also attracts the objects. And I will show you one interesting property of a magnet. I already show you, when we suspended a bar magnet, it always shows north and south directions. Then why it is showing north and south directions only? That means it is affected by another magnet. Because of that only it always shows. Which magnet affects this bar magnet, suspended bar magnet? That is a earth. Now I will show you with the help of this experiment. Here we took two bar magnets. First magnet is placed on the table and the second magnet is suspended freely with the help of thread. See, south and north directions on the table. Suspended magnet showing opposite directions here. When I change the direction of the first magnet, see, the suspended magnet's directions also changed. See? Yeah. Why the suspended bar magnet always shows north and south directions means, the magnet which is below it is affecting the directions of this magnet. That means our earth magnet, our earth is acting as a magnet. Our earth is a big magnet. So that is why it is also acting on the suspended magnet. That is why it is showing always north and south directions, like which is shown in the video. Okay, children, do you agree with that? Okay. Now, make your own magnet. Is that really happens? Can we make our own magnet? Yes. With the help of this activity, I will show you how to make our own magnet. First, what we have to do? take a bar magnet and a nail, iron nail. Rub on the magnet like that for 20 to 30 times. Now observe this. This iron nail acting as a magnet now and attracting the ball pin. That means we made our own magnet. Okay. Now try to make our own compass. For that, what we needed? We need the glass with water. Wooden piece, bar magnet, ball pins, and another one ball magnet, which is which we want to suspend it later. So we tied it with the thread. And now make your own magnet by rubbing it on this bar magnet. That means I am making ball pin as magnet here now. First I want to make the ball pin as magnet. For that I am doing like that. Okay, now the ball pin made as a magnet. Place the wooden piece on water very slowly. Now really a needle make becomes a magnet. See, it really become a magnet. So it is attracting the other ball pins. So now place it on the wooden plate. That ball pin is a magnet now, so it shows the directions of north and south. Is it really happens? Yeah, it really happens. Do this activity at your home and observe. Is it really shows north and south directions or not? By suspending a bar magnet with the help of thread, I am showing you the directions of north and south. This magnet is showing like the same way that needle placed on the wooden spoon, wooden plate, also showing the same directions. That means what we made now. See the directions, north and south, it is showing like the same way it is showing the north and south directions. Hey, we made our own magnetic compass. This compass is showing the directions. Okay, later I am moving on to another topic, that is magnetic induction. What is magnetic induction? Let us see what it is. Take a safety pin, try to attach that with the ball pin. Is it attracting? That safety pin is attracting the ball pin? No, it is not happening. Then observe this activity. In this activity, what we are using? A bar magnet, ball pins and safety pin. First, what is happened now? Safety pin attracted the ball pins here. That means here safety pin is attracted by bar magnet first. That safety pin is attracting the ball pins. What happened in the first case? Safety pin is alone is not attracting the ball pin. But when it is attached to another magnet, then it is capable of attracting the ball pin. And what we call this property? If the safety pin is not in contact with the bar magnet, can it attract the ball pin? No, it cannot attract the ball pin. What happens if we place the bar magnet very close to the safety pin but not touching it? Even though it not touching it, that safety pin attracts the ball pin. That is called magnetic induction. Okay? Magnetic property possessed by a magnetic substance due to the presence of magnet near it is called magnetic induction. Okay, children, have you seen it? Okay, right now I want to show you one interesting one in the final one video. I want to help you out to make your own magnetic toy or a gift to give that gift to your friend on his or her on her birthday. For that, what we require: scissors, tape, pen, ring magnet, disc magnet, cycle iron ray, and DVD or CD. What we have to do, we have to bend the iron ray like this and place this ray on the DVD. With the help of tape, what we have to do, we have to attach this iron ray to the DVD with the help of this sellotape. I fixed this ray on the DVD, and now my students are doing, they kept the magnet over the iron ray here, and now they are keeping the ring magnets to the pen. See what they are doing. Yeah, pen is standing in the air without any support. How does this happen? Are you observing it? Magnetic pen holder. We prepared it. Pen is, it is hold with the help of the attraction between these two magnets. Because of the property of attraction power, we can make this magnetic pen stands. Okay. Try at your home, prepare this and give your friend. Okay children, summary now. Shape of what we have seen up to yet: shapes of different magnets, uses of magnets in our daily life, magnetic and non-magnetic materials, magnet preparation, magnetic compass preparation, magnetic induction, toy preparation, magnetic toy preparation. Okay, now evaluation. Prepare your own magnet at your home. If you were given with a material, how can you find whether it is a magnetic or non-magnetic one? Maha said that Earth is a big magnet. Do you support her statement? Why? Write the uses of magnets in our daily life. How many shapes of magnets observed by you in this lesson? What are they? Write the procedure and materials required to make your own magnetic compass. Okay? Okay children, I will meet you again with another topic. Until then, bye. Thanks for watching.